Hi listeners, welcome to the video on support vector machines. In this video, we are going to look into an example problem on support vector machines. Support vector machines are generally used in classification problems. Classification problem in the sense, classification problem can be viewed as the task of separating classes in the feature space. So let us assume an example of data, which is something like what I am showing here. I have two features x1 and x2, and the data of these two features are marked into groups something like this. The set of data belongs to class 0. This is what I call it as class 0 or minus 1 group, and there is another set of data which belongs to class 1 group. So this belongs to class 1 group. So this type of problem is what we call it as classification problem. The main important aim of this classification problem is to find out a decision boundary which could able to classify these two points very clearly. That means I am going to find a line between these two classes, something like this, so that I can say whatever the point which lies to the right of the line belongs to class 1, and if the point is falling on the left of the line, it belongs to class 0 or minus 1 class. So I want to find out a line which lies between these two classes, which this line is what I call it as decision boundary line. So this is what it is generally done in the case of perceptron. Perceptron algorithm also find out a line which is going to classify or which is going to act as a boundary between the two classes of classification. But let us look into a problem which is little bit different than what I was showing right now. Now if I say I have two classes something like this, then there are infinite number of lines which is going to separate these two classes. Say let us say this is a line which is going to separate these two classes. So if I say this is going to be the decision boundary, then all the points to the right of this line belongs to class 1 and all the points to the left of this line belongs to class of minus 1. This is not only the only line which is going to separate these two classes. You can just look into this line. This line also does the same job. So this line, if I look at this line right of this line belongs to class 1. And to the left of this line belongs to minus 1 class. So again, this line also does the same job. Not only this line, you can just look into this line. This line also does the same job. Now, I have many lines which is something like this. I can draw many lines something like this which can separate these two of classes in this example. But my question is, which is going to be the best line of these three lines? So, best line among the available lines, I want to find out. To do that, I can use the algorithm called as support vector machines. Perceptron also does the same job, but the perceptron will not find out the best line. Once the classes are separated, the algorithm gets stopped in the perceptron. But it does not find out the best line to fit in. What is the problem with this if the line is not best? Is an important question. So let us look into the line something like this. So if I look into the line something like this, if this is going to act as a decision boundary, say for example, I get a new class which is new point which comes in here. This looks like a red point, but as this is a decision boundary, this particular problem, this point will be classified as blue. But since this is very close to this red point will be in class minus 1. But since it is falling out to the right of this line, I may classify this point as blue. So this is the problem. So I want to find out an optimal line which is going to segregate or which is going to act as a decision boundary between these two. So I want to find out the midway between the classes of classification. So this is what the support vector machines do. So now let us look into a problem. By taking into the problem, I want to find out which particular line is going to act as a best line by using an algorithm called as support vector machine algorithm. So now let us take a two feature problem. There is two features x1 and x2 and the labels of those two features are also given here. The first point is 1,1 and this is supposed to be in minus 1 class. 2,1 is the another data point which is going to be in minus 1 class. So I have 4 data points which belongs to minus 1 class and I have another 4 data points which belongs to plus 1 class. Now let us try to plot all these data points into a simple 2D structure and let us try to understand what is going to happen. So now let us try to take the first data point, this data point, and try to plot it. So 1,1 data point will be appearing somewhere here. So this is going to be the first data point and this I mark it as red since this is a label of minus 1. Now let us go into the next point, this 2,1 point, and let us again plot it in the 2D feature space, that is x1 and x2. Let us try to plot this again in x1 and x2. And if you look at the second point, this 2D point, the second point, this point 2,1, and this also belongs to minus 1. And now let us go into the third point 3,-1 and try to plot it. And if I plot 3,-1, I will get something, 1,-1, third point 1,-1, I will get something here and which is also belongs to minus 1 label. Now let us go into the fourth data point which is 2,-1, 2,-1 point will be somewhere here and that is also belonging to minus 1 class. Now we are going to plot the next data, that is 4,0 point and which belongs to plus 1 class, which will be appearing somewhere here, and the fifth data point 5,1 and which belongs to 1 label, which is going to somewhere here, and this is going to be the point 5,1, and this point, the next one 5,-1, will be somewhere here, and this is the point for 5,-1, and the last point is 6,0, which is going to be somewhere here. Now my ultimate objective is to find out an optimum line. Even though you can say there are lot of lines which could able to separate between these two, I want to find out an ultimate best line among the all available lines. So that was my main objective here. Now let us go into the looking into the possible lines that can separate. You can see that all these lines are going to separate the class 1 and class minus 1. I want to find out which line is supposed to be the best line of this available class, available lines. So I want to find out the best line which could able to separate these two. Now if you look at, this is the area where the lines can be drawn, infinite lines can be drawn. So I want to find out the line which is, this is the common area. This area, if you look at, this is the common area between the points of classification. This is the common area between the points of classification. So I can draw any number of lines between these two and say this is going to classify my data points, but that line may not be the best line. So I want to find out the best line among the available lines in this particular classification problem. So let us try to look into option called as support vectors. So just look into these points. This point is supposed to be the one point which is going to say that this if I move away from this point, then this point becomes class 0 or minus 1 class. So this is going to be a point which I call it as support vector 1, and this is the another point which is going to separate the classes. So this is going to be the support vector 2, and this is going to be the support vector 3. So these three points is going to decide my decision boundary. So if I try to draw a line something like this, if I move away from this point in the left side direction, if I move like this, this point is going to act as my restriction point. So this is the area, as I told you, this is the common area. So these three points are going to act as the support points. So these three points are called as support vectors. So there are three support vectors for me. S1 is the first support vector, and S2 is my second support vector, and S3 is going to be my third support vector. So let me try to draw all these support vectors very clearly for better understanding. So this is my support vector 1, support vector 1, and this is my support vector 2, and this is my support vector 3. I call these as support vectors because this, between these points only I have some common area of classification. So let us try to write this support vector 1. Support vector 1 is 2, 1 point. So I write it as 2, 1. This is support vector 1. Support vector 2 is 2, minus 1 point. So this is 2, minus 1 point. Support vector 2 point. And support vector 3 point is 4, 0 point. 4, 0 point. If you look at this point is 40 point, this is 2, 1 point, and this is 2, -1 point. So if you look at all these three points are going to act as a support vectors of classification. So that is what I have written here, S1, S2 and S3. So these three points are called as support vectors, and the points are also denoted as vector 2, 1, 2, minus 1 and 4, 0. Now what I am going to do, I am going to add a bias for all these points. Let the bias be 1. So what I do, I add 1 along with this support vector, which I call it as bias B. So this is supposed to be the bias. This is what I call it as bias. So similarly, for the support vector 2 also, I add a bias 1. And for support vector 3 also, I add a bias 1. So this is a bias which I add purposely in order to make my support vector machine algorithms to work. So ultimately, I have found out a support vector from my data points available in my data. And to that, I add a bias point of 1. So all these support vectors, and now I call this S1 as S1 tilde and S2 as S2 tilde and S3 as S3 tilde. So I have three support vectors. From these three support vectors, I derived this S1 tilde, S2 tilde and S3 tilde by adding a bias of 1 to all this. Now my next step is to find out three parameters alpha 1, alpha 2 and alpha 3 based on the linear equations which I try to put here. Now these three points, if you look at these three points, this S1, S2 and S3, this S1 belongs to minus 1 class, this S1 belongs to minus 1 class, this S2 is also belonging to minus 1 class, and S3, if you look at this S1 belongs to minus 1 class, S2 belongs to minus 1 class, and if S3 is belonging to plus 1 class. So this is equal to plus 1. So the three points, S1 belongs to minus 1, S2 belongs to minus 1 and S3 belongs to plus 1. So based on this, I am going to write equation alpha 1 into S1 tilde dot product of S1 tilde plus alpha 2 into S2 tilde dot product of S1 tilde plus alpha 3 into S3 tilde dot product of S1 tilde, and this minus 1 is, since S1 is belonging to minus 1 class, so I write it as minus 1. So what I try to do, I try to say is, since this is belonging to minus 1 and this is also belonging to minus 1 and this is belonging to plus 1, so I try to put this S1 tilde in minus 1 class, S2 tilde in minus 1 class and S3 tilde in plus 1 class, and I try to write this expression alpha 1 into S1 dot S1 dot S1 dot S1, alpha 2 into S2 dot S1 and alpha 3 into S3 dot S1, which is equal to minus 1. Now I write the second equation. So this is for S1, and now I write the second equation for S2, which is alpha 1 into S1 tilde dot S2 tilde, alpha 2 into S2 tilde dot S2 tilde and alpha 3 into S3 tilde dot S2 tilde, which is also belonging to minus 1. So this is this is for S1 and this is for S2. Now I write it for S3. S3 is alpha 1 into S1 tilde dot S3 tilde, alpha 2 into S2 tilde dot S3 tilde, and alpha 3 is equals to into S3 tilde dot S3 tilde, which is equal to plus 1. Now we know that the expressions for S1, S2, S3 tilde are given here, which is the support vector added with bias element. Now I use these three elements and substitute in this expression. Now we could able to see alpha 1 into S1 tilde dot S1 tilde. So 211. S1 tilde is 211 dot 211 plus alpha 2 into S2 tilde. S2 is this expression. So 211 2 minus 1 1 into S1. S1 is 211, so I put 211 plus alpha 3 into S3. S3 tilde is 401, which is given here, 401, and this is 211 is S1 tilde, so which is given here. So similarly for alpha 1 into S1 tilde, which is 211, into S2 tilde, which is 2 minus 11, which is given here. And alpha 2 into 2 minus 11 into 2 minus 11, because both are S2 tilde into S2 tilde dot S2 tilde, and alpha 3 into S3 tilde dot S2 tilde, which is what it is given here, which is equal to minus 1. Similarly, alpha 1 into 211, which is S1 tilde, 401, which is S3 tilde, and alpha 2 into 2 minus 11, which is S2 tilde, 401, which is S3 tilde. Similarly, I write for the third expression also. Now, after writing this expression, I am going to make simple mathematics and calculate what is the values of these linear expressions. So, if I try to write this, alpha 1 into 2 into 2, 4, plus 1 into 1 is 1, plus 1 into 1 is 1, plus alpha 2 into alpha 2 into 2 into 2 is 4, plus 1 into minus 1 is minus 1, plus 1 into 1 is 1, plus alpha 3 into 4 into 2 is 8, plus 0 into 1 is 0, plus 1 into 1 is 0, which is equal to minus 1. So what I get, 4 plus 1 plus 1, 6 alpha 1, 6 alpha 1, let me write it here, this is 6 alpha 1 plus this plus 1 and minus 1, this and this will get cancelled out. So, plus 4 alpha 2 plus this 8 and 1 added together. So, this becomes 9 alpha 3 equal to minus 1. So this is my first expression. My second expression is, I'm going to make use here. So alpha 1 into this vector multiplied with this vector. So 2 into 2, 4, minus 1, plus 1, plus alpha 2 into 4, minus minus plus 1, plus 1. So 4 plus 1 plus 1. 4 plus 1 plus 1 is 4 plus 1 plus 1. 4 plus 1 plus 1 plus alpha 3 into 4 plus 4 into 2 is 8 plus 0 plus 1 equal to minus 1. So we'll get 4 alpha 1, 4 alpha 1 plus 6 alpha 2 plus 9 alpha 3 equal to minus 1. So this is my second expression. My first expression is this, and my second expression is this. And if I look at again, I can write alpha 1 into 4 into 2 is 8 plus 0 plus 1 plus alpha 2 into 4 into 2 is 8 plus 0 plus 1 plus alpha 3 into 4 into 4 is 16 plus 0 plus 1 equal to 1. So I'll get 9 alpha 1 plus 9 alpha 2 plus 17 alpha 3 equal to 1. So this is my third expression. So I have three expressions. Now I want to solve for all these three expressions. Let me write all these three expressions here for better understanding. So from the previous slide, I get 6 alpha 1 plus 4 alpha 2 plus 9 alpha 3 equal to minus 1. This is my equation 1. My equation 2 is 4 alpha 1 plus 6 alpha 2 plus 6 alpha 2 plus 9 alpha 3 equal to minus 1. This is my second expression. And third expression is 9 alpha 1 plus 9 alpha 2 plus 17 alpha 3 equal to plus 1. So this is my third expression. So when I try to solve all these expressions, I will get alpha 1 equal to alpha 2 equal to minus 3.25. You can make use of your calculator for solving these three linear equations. So if I solve this, I will get alpha 1 equal to alpha 2 equal to minus 3.25, and alpha 3 is equal to 3.5. So this is the values of alpha 1 and alpha 2 which I get. So once I get this value, my next step, this is my next step. Next step is to find out a W tilde, which is equal to summation of I into alpha I SI. Alpha I SI. Now I have three support vectors. So I equal to 3 here. So when I use this, I will get alpha 1 S1 plus alpha 2 S2 plus alpha 3 S3 is what I get it. So alpha 1 is minus 3.25 into support vector 1 is given in the previous slide. You can just go back and look into this. S1 tilde is alpha 211. So I'll get 211. This is S1 tilde. You can just use this tilde. S1 tilde. Everything is tilde. So 211 is my first support vector. And the second alpha 2 is also 3.25, which is 2 minus 1, 1. And the third one, alpha 3, is 3.5 into 4, 0, 1. this S1 tilde, S2 tilde and S3 tilde has been taken from the previous slide which is given here. So this is what the values of W. So if I simplify this, I will get W as 103. So if I simplify this expression, I will get W is equals to 103. If you remember in my previous slide, I mentioned that I have added a bias from S1 to S1 tilde. I have added a bias. So which means this last value here, this 3 is what we call it as bias. So this is supposed to be the weight vector, which is 10, and the bias vector is equal to 3. This is actually, I'll get minus 3 here. So this bias vector is equal to minus 3. So if we simplify, I'll get 10 and minus 3, not plus 3. It is 10 and minus 3. You can just have a clear look of this. So this is 10 and minus 3. So let me write it here, 10 and minus 3. So this bias is equal to minus 3. So now I want to, from this, I can conclude that this is the line which is going to separate my data points, and this line is supposed to be the best line. This line is supposed to be my best line. So how I can say this? Let us go into the next C and see this. So now W is 10. And B is equal to minus 3. This is what I get from my support vector machine algorithm. So this is the line which is going to separate my positive and negative classes, that is minus 1 class and plus 1 class. So among the infinite number of lines available within this margin, or available area, this line is going to separate my two classes of classes, which is going to be the best line. And this is what we call it as support vector machines. So you can just look into, substitute this y equal to wx plus b, which we have seen already in our classes. So w is 10, x is x1, x2 and minus 3. So y is equals to x1 minus 3 is my expression for this particular class. So this is the line which is going to separate these two classes of classification. With this, the support vector machine problem is solved. Thank you for your patient listening. And this problem is a problem which is used in support vector machine analytical. Thank you.